National Teachers Day on 5th September dates back to 1962, and this date being the birth anniversary of Dr. S. Radhakrishnan, a timeless teacher and former president of Indian Republic. There is no right or wrong way to describe a teacher. Teachers are not limited to academic success. Teachers are beacons of light, guiding us through innovative paths and molding us through the same. However, very often we fail to show our gratitude and respect to these teachers and their utter devotion. Hence, with all due respect, on this auspicious occasion, I am beyond grateful to welcome each and every one of you to my annual Teachers' Day celebration here at Bhavan Sudhyashram, where our students take an opportunity to honor our wonderful teachers. Thank you.
From 11th standard, and I am here to talk about communicable diseases from your science textbook as part of our own Teachers' Day celebrations. So, what are communicable diseases? Communicable diseases are diseases which are spread from one person to another. For example, cholera, typhoid, as you know, COVID, and Nipah, etc. So, who causes these communicable diseases? These communicable diseases are caused by microbes or microorganisms. We call these microbes or microorganisms as germs. There are mainly four types of germs: viruses, bacteria, protozoa, and fungi. So how do these diseases spread? These diseases spread in four ways: from a person to another person, by water or food, by air, or by insect bites. from a person to another person. When an infected person gets in contact with a healthy person, the germs gets passed on to their body and spreads the disease. For example, measles, influenza, etc. by food and water. When these germs are present in a food or water, this food or water is said to be contaminated. When any healthy person eats or drinks this contaminated food or water, they get the disease. Example, cholera, typhoid, etc. By insect bites, mainly mosquitoes and bugs feed on human or other animal bloods. When a mosquito or bug or a bug bites the infected person and passes on to our body, we get the disease. Because when this mosquito bites, they not only carries the blood but also the germs from the infected person's body. So we get so the germs gets inside our body and causes the disease. Example, dengue, malaria, and chikungunya. So that's all, friends. I hope all of you got me, and that's all. Thank you.
Good morning, children. Do you know what is the speciality of today? Yes, today is Teacher's Day. On behalf of this, we 11th standard students have got an opportunity to take classes for you. First of all, myself, I am Arvya, and I am going to just summarize the third chapter of your history textbook. Now, at present, we buy fruits or vegetables that are grown up. Earlier, people did not have the knowledge of farming or cultivating. They used to gather fruits, nuts, etc., or hunt animals. Farming developed as a result of climate change. People began to observe the differences when the climate changes. At some particular climate, some plants grew well, whereas some did not. This made them to think, and gradually, as a result, farming developed. People also got interested in taming animals. Taming means domesticating. Hope you to have a pet at home. And people also domesticated cows, goats, sheep, etc., and they became herders as well. And this is all about the chapter. Now, read it and mark the important points. That's all. Thank you.
Namaste, children. I am Chaitra. So, I am taking 7th standard political science. So, our first chapter is about on equality. So, I am taking a small portion on it. So, before that, I want to ask one question. What do you mean by equality? So, I want just an idea about equality. So, equality means everyone is getting fair chance or opportunities. So, this equality is seen in our country. Or before that, I want to ask one question. What is constitution? So, constitution is a body that contains all fundamental principles or rules, and based on that, the citizens of a country are governed. So, in our constitution, or our constitution guarantees universal adult franchise. So, what do you mean by universal adult franchise? All adults above 18 are allowed to cast one vote. So, that is what we call universal adult franchise. So, all the adults above 18 are allowed to cast one vote, irrespective of their religion, caste, education, gender, wealth, etc. But equality can be seen in our real life or in our society? No. The most common inequality that's seen in our country is caste system. If you are in rural India, then you are exposed to caste system in younger age itself. urban areas, then we can see small amount of cash inequality. The example it is, when we come to matrimonial annual, we can see the caste inequalities. So how to bring equality? For that I told, caste inequality is there, then some wealth inequalities are there. I mean those who have wealth and not can access to everything. I mean good school, good hospital, etc. Like then there are many inequalities. So how to bring equality? So based on that, our constitution had laid down some principle. So first one is, everyone is equal before law. That is, whether prime minister, domestic worker or president, everyone are equal before law. That means everyone want to follow same rules and laws. So second one is, there should be no discrimination based on gender, caste, religion, position, wealth, etc. And third one is, everyone can access to public places. That is, whether school, hospitals, education institution, theatres, etc. Everyone can access to public places. And fourth one is, untouchability is banned. So these are some guidelines to follow equality in India. So thank you.
Hey everyone, I'm Malavika. Today I'm going to take an introduction for the chapter Indigence. 1, 2, 3, etc. are known as counting numbers or natural numbers. And 0, 1, 2, 3 are known as whole numbers. So whole numbers is the set of 0 and natural numbers, right? Okay. Now, to the set of whole numbers, I'm adding the set of negative numbers. So it becomes 93, 92, 91, 0, 1, 2, 3. What is this set known as? Integers. So, integers. It is a combination of negative numbers, positive numbers and 0. Or you can tell integers is a combination of whole numbers and negative numbers. Integers is denoted by the letter Z. So now let us look some examples. Negative 200, 1000, all these integers, right? 0, 1, 2, minus 1, minus 2, everything is examples. There are tons of examples for integers. Now let's represent integers in a number line. Okay, so it is 0, 1, 2, 3, 91, 92, 93. This is enough. So what is this? This is a set of counting numbers. I am just already counting, you may understand. This is a set of whole numbers. And this is a whole set of integers. This part is negative numbers. So, integers is the combination of whole numbers and negative numbers. That together brings the integers. Now, from 0 towards the right, what is it? Positive numbers. And from 0 towards the left, it is negative numbers. That's all for today. Thank you.
Good morning children, I am Adityan Thiruman from class 11. Today I am going to take about shapes and angles. I think you have heard about shapes and angles in early classes, right? So I will show you one example. So look at this example. Yes, you can see it, right? Yes, this is a hexagon. That means it has six sides. You can see this, right? So my question is it a closed shape? Yes, this is a closed shape, as you can see this. Let me show you one more example. So look at this figure. You can see this, right? This is a pentagon. That means it has five sides. So I have marked each angle with each color. You can see that this angle with rose color, these two angles with green color, and these two angles with blue color. So my question is, the angle marked in which color is the biggest angle? So you can see this. You can look this carefully. So you can see that the angle marked with green color is the biggest one. It's really simple, right? So I will give you one puzzle. It's really interesting. So my question is, using 6 matchsticks, you have to make 8 triangles. How now? Like this. I have used 6 matchsticks and I have made 8 triangles with this. You can do similarly. I have shown you one example like this. So let me count the triangles. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 small triangles, right? 6 small triangles using this six mastics, and we can see that big triangles, right? Yeah, this one, big triangle. And one more triangle, upside down, right? This. So we have made 8 triangles using 6 mastics. Thank you.
Hello everyone, I am Aditya Vinaya here as part of the Teacher's Day to take a small introduction on the chapter Integers for my 6th standard friends. So, what is this Integers? Before knowing about that, you must know about two things. The natural numbers and the whole numbers. The natural numbers, yeah, the common numbers we use like the 1, 2, 3 and so on. Then the whole numbers, yeah, it includes 0 also, that is 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. Then, apart of these two, if we include negative numbers, that is negative 1, negative 2, negative 3 and so on, then this set is called the integers. So, it includes negative numbers as well as the whole numbers. You must be thinking that these negative numbers are not in part of our usual days. But I will prove it with you an example. So, if you go to a shop and buy a 5 rupee pen, and without even using that, you want to lend him back and ask him to lend the 5 rupees back. But if the shopkeeper refuses and says that it's already a sold product, so he cannot pay the full money and only pays you 2 rupees, then you have got a 3 rupee loss. So here, we have got 5 minus 2, 3, but it is indicated as minus 3, because the minus here indicates a loss. But you know, there is no money called minus 3 rupees. Similarly, even we indicate the temperature of places like minus 10 degrees Celsius and a very high temperature, we say 50 degrees Celsius. Hence, these signs leave some matter. So, the numbers which are negative side, that is on the left side of the graph, is called the negative integers, and the numbers which is positive and on the right side is called the positive integers. Thank you.
Good morning, sir. I'm Shreya. Today we are going to start a new chapter in geography, major domains of the earth. Speaking about earth, you would have studied in the earlier chapter itself that earth is the only planet in the solar system where life is found. Why so? You would know that earth has some elements like land, air and water. These help in the survival of living things. So in earth, there are mainly 4 domains: lithosphere, biosphere, hydrosphere and atmosphere. Let us study about it in detail in this chapter. First one is lithosphere. What is lithosphere? Lithosphere is the solid portion of the earth, and it is also portion of the earth where we live. Moving on to the second one, it is atmosphere. Atmosphere is the gaseous portion around the earth, and it is also the portion where we find gases like oxygen, carbon dioxide, nitrogen, etc. Next one is hydrosphere. What do you mean by hydrosphere? Children, you would know that hydro means water. And you would always know that earth has many parts of water. Earth is covered by water in many parts. So, these area covered by water on the earth's surface is known as hydrosphere. Hydrosphere consists of water in all of its forms. Then the last one is biosphere. It is the zone where we find all the 3 elements, that is land, air and water, all together. And this portion consists of all life forms. So children, now I have given you an introduction to the 4 domains, that is lithosphere, hydrosphere, atmosphere and biosphere. In this chapter, you will further study about each of these domains detailed. So, thank you, children.
Good morning, children. I'm Pavan Harish of class 11 and I'll be taking English for class 6 today. I'm going to teach you about simple present tense. Simple present tense is written in the form subject plus V1. You might have learned this in 5th grade. So, there are 4 main uses of simple present tense. Simple present tense is used to express repeated actions. For example, I go for a walk daily. This action is repeated every day. I go for a walk each and every day. Then the next use is for expressing universal truth. For example, the sun rises in the east. It is a universal truth or a general truth or a fact which we are supposed to know. Then the next use is for expressing scheduled actions. For example, the train leaves at 8 a.m. The train is supposed to or scheduled to leave at 8 a.m. Such sentences are also expressed using simple present tense. Then, the last one is, it is used to express habits or abilities. For example, he plays violin. He, who is the subject, knows how to play violin, or he has an ability to play violin. Such sentences are also expressed using simple present tense. Thank you and have a nice day.
Good morning everyone. Today, I am going to teach you a chapter called So. In this, we learn about how a boy handles a situation where people show bad manners or try to cheat each other. So in this story, this boy goes to the shop to buy some soap. And the shopkeeper gives him a bad soap or defective soap. And seeing this, the boy gets angry. Because as you all know, we're paying full money for it and still the shopkeeper is giving bad product. So seeing this, the boy gets very angry and starts calling the shopkeeper very vulgar words. Without thinking. As he sees this, lots of people come around and start accusing the boy of doing such bad things. And on hearing this, he understands that he acted really wrongly and says sorry to the shopkeeper and takes the soap and goes away. This is what happens. Later on, the boy thinks about this, what happened, and talks about how he was in the wrong. Because even though the shopkeeper gave him bad product, he should have talked nicely and smoothly with the shopkeeper and decided to figure it out. But instead, he got really angry and accused the shopkeeper and called him very bad words. So this talks about how calling bad words at people is not the solution to our problems, and we should always talk about different solutions. If the boy had instead talked to the shopkeeper and told him it was a defective product, and he would have asked for a different product. But instead he got angry and called bad words, and this resulted in more people coming in and getting angry at him instead of the shopkeeper. This is an incident of how we should always be aware of our surroundings and treat people with kindness and respect. That's it.
Hello, I'm Tricia. Today I'm going to take class on the topic environment. Do you know what is environment? This topic is familiar to many of us. So, the environment is the nature which surrounds the living organism. Early humans were adaptive to the nature themselves. They lived a simple life and all their requirements were fulfilled by the environment. Later, humans learned the various ways to use the environment and they modified environment. Then, wheel was invented, commerce was produced and many things was done and transport was made easier. While we were busy making all these things, we failed to realize that we have harmed many organisms or the environment itself. We polluted the water bodies where all the fishes and organisms live, and a large scale of deforestation was done which made many birds and animals homeless. So we need to take steps to protect all these things and environment. So for that we are taking a small step, which is the 3 R's or the 3 principles of R's: reuse, recycle and reduce. We should reduce the usage of water and electricity and recycle the old things, and we need to reuse the bags. We should all make an attitude of recycle, reduce and reuse. Thank you.
Good morning students. My name is Aranya, taking class 4, 6 standard. So the chapter's name is water. What are the essential things in our life? Yes, air and water. Air for breathing and water. Without water, we cannot live. And suppose your family gets only one bucket of water every day. That water will not be enough for you to cook food, wash utensils, or wash clothes or bath, etc. So, if water is not there for a long period of time, people might die because they will not get enough water for drinking, etc. So you all know the importance of water now. So how can we conserve water? Yes, conservation of water can be done by a method called rainwater harvesting, then by a common method called closing taps and fixing the leaks of taps, etc. So only a small portion of water available on earth can be fit for use of plants, animals and human beings. the most of the water is found in ocean, so the water cannot be used directly. Then when the level of groundwater decreases, that water cannot be used anymore. The amount of total amount of water on Earth remains constant increases by overusing it. So the demand of water is increasing day by day. Number of people using the water is increasing by rising population, and more water is used for making food processing and industrial purposes. And you have seen people standing in long queues for getting water and all. So these are the factors leading to shortage of water in many parts of the country. Hence, it is very important to carefully use the water, and we should take care not to waste water. I think all have understood the questions. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Kirtan Kirundi and I am studying in class 11th. Today, I am here to take class for the students of class 7th on the lesson Soil and Biology. So, soil is one of the most important natural resources. It is the home for many organisms, from microorganisms to very large animals like us. Many plants, herbs, shrubs, very large trees, they all live on the soil. Now, what are the uses of the soil? We cultivate on the soil, which is known as agriculture, and soil is used for many other purposes like building, for many medicinal purposes, for many beauty products. So that for all that, soil is used. Now, what is soil profile? There are many different layers of the soil. A vertical section through different layers of the soil is known as the soil profile. And each of these layers is known as horizon. So, the first layer, that is first horizon, is known as A horizon. Next comes the B horizon, next comes the C horizon, and at last the bedrock.
Dancing is the hidden language of the soul. Next up, we have a dance by some of my classmates. The only thing better than singing is more singing. Next, we have a song by Lakshmi.
Yeah. to do our best. You help us strive for our goals. We found love, friendship, guidance, and everything in one person. That person is you. Happy Teachers' Day to all the lovely teachers out there.
Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwara, Guru Sakshat Parabrahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwara, Guru Sakshat Parabrahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwara, Guru Sakshat Parabrahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha.
नन्हे से कदम लेकर जब आए पहली बार, नन्हे से कदम लेकर जब आए पहली बार, थामी हमारी उंगली उस टीचर को हमारा प्यार।
तो बोलो गुरु ब्रह्मा, गुरु विष्णु, गुरु देवो महेश्वरा, गुरु साक्षात परब्रह्मा, तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः।
उठते और संभलते हैं हम, थक भी जाएं पर देखो वो कभी न थकते हैं। वो टीचर ही तो है जो हमारे साथ चलते हैं, हमारे साथ चलते हैं।
तो बोलो गुरु ब्रह्मा, गुरु विष्णु, गुरु देवो महेश्वरा, गुरु साक्षात परब्रह्मा, तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः।
श्रद्धा से नया विश्वास जगाते हैं। वो टीचर ही तो है जो सच्ची राह दिखाते हैं, सच्ची राह दिखाते हैं।
तो बोलो गुरु ब्रह्मा, गुरु विष्णु, गुरु देवो महेश्वरा, गुरु साक्षात परब्रह्मा, तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः।
नन्हे से कदम लेकर जब आए पहली बार, नन्हे से कदम लेकर जब आए पहली बार, थामी हमारी उंगली उस टीचर को हमारा प्यार। नन्हे से कदम लेकर